Leg movement is based on a parallelogram mechanism. This avoids the use of joints like gears that can generate play on the structure. Source of backlash in this configuration comes only from the precision of bearings, the flexible nature of plastic and servo gears. After some fan trigonometry to obtain the inverse kinematics, I was able to verify that with the previous mechanism the tibial motor must travel more arc of angle than with the new one. Another improvement that makes the leg dynamics more ideal is having the motor closer to the rotating axis, so moment arc is small, which implies that fast movement does not affect the whole robot dynamics. At first I tried to do something like a 3D contact sensor. It seemed very promising, but calibration of resistive sensor requires complex maths or even EA approaches. Apart from that, reliability wasn't good, so I scraped the idea and decided to read all internal encoders of the servos as a feedback to characterize the states of the robot. For now, feed contacts are made of TPU plastic, printed with just one perimeter and 3% infill density to make the pad very flexible to absorb ground impact, and at the same time footprint will increase under load. This material is not very grippy, but this would help not to fold motors in case of slippery. It is time to power the motors. To make life easier, I designed a distribution PCB in order to interface microcontroller with servos and their own power supply, along some other stuff like analog input of each motor's encoder. To manufacture it, I decided to ask for the help of PCBWay. Their service helped me since the first moment, solving questions about the manufacturing processes, and it was very easy to upload Gerber files and tune all parameters to simulate the finished board. They also have a lot of other manufacturing services. You can check their page in the description of the video. Thanks to PCBWay for helping me making the project better and manufacturing this PCB for a very small budget. But the best is that I just got my new boards at home in less than 2 weeks to Spain. To place servos at their real angles, it's always useful to make a calibration tool. Then, a simple program can be written to interpolate servos to match the output angles of the inverse kinematic model. Two known angles are saved. This way we can calculate a linear relation between PWM signal and commanded real angles. Also, this program interpolates encoder's input, doing several swift movements to collect data and do a fitting cool. With that, the noisy analog data can be passed through a Kalman filtering, and we can say actuator characterization is done kind of a precisely way, if all parameters are set correctly. Of course, I believe it can be done better. This new leg mechanism has shown significant improvement compared to the previous one, and it is implemented in a very special robot that I hope I would be able to share it very soon, including all files and code. Thanks everyone for watching the video!